guys, Corey here. I have got a gym here today. I have got what you consider basically a training ground for new guys. This is one of those ones where you come in and you realize you can throw caution to the wind. These are the ones that you learn the most on. We've got a heavily soiled brown carpet that is in dire need of being torn out. But we're not tearing it out, we're gonna clean it. But we're gonna go around front and I'm gonna show you. This is a client of mine that owns a handful of properties around town, and I take care of them all, the carpet and all that jazz and all of them. But we're gonna take a look at what I saw when I first pulled up, and take you through what I thought might have been going on here when I first pulled up. So let me show you. All right, that's what I saw when I first pulled up. I'm gonna sit down here in a race car right now. I don't know who that is. Anyway, I'm gonna look at the house here. All right, yeah. So in here, it smells like the bottom of a cigarette ashtray. That's what it smells like. So this is the living room here. We got hallway that's ruined. This room here that's beyond gone. We're gonna clean this though. I'm gonna clean this anyway. I don't know what room I'm gonna make about the whole cleaning process, but one of them we are. This one here, this is one of the ones where I'd totally make up the whole cleaning solution here out of the strongest things I can imagine. And a whole lot of peroxide. And there will be a lot of ammonia used in this one here. So, and when I get done, I'm gonna put down chlorine dioxide before I leave. I'm gonna put down a healthy coat of that so we can try to kill whatever odors. I would mix it in with a cleaner that I'm gonna be cleaning with. However, I will be cleaning at least 14 pH. So the CLO2 will not live in that high of a pH range. So I'm gonna have to apply that in a second step when I leave here. All right, I'm going to put me some free spray together. And you can see over here that I've already got some in the bucket here. Now, I've made a bunch of videos about making up chemicals and stuff, and I don't want anybody to think that I think I'm a chemist. I've had a little, I won't say altercation with a guy, but disrespected a little bit. I'm trying to, hang on a second. Anyway, I was talking to a guy, he made some sarcastic comment about putting chemicals together doesn't make you a chemist. It means you're just pouring chemicals together, which exactly is what I'm doing here. I'm not a chemist. I took criminal justice in college. So clearly not a chemist. You need to have the basics, understand the basics of chemistry, how chemistry works. And we're gonna be functioning on an alkaline pH here. So we're gonna put together something really strong. Now we've got Zep in here now. And I want you to keep in mind the close measurements that I'm using here and how important that is for me to get a good outcome here. Because I'm not leaving until I'm done. So I want you to, when people ask me, hey Corey, how much of this, how much of that, how much of this, how much of that? We're gonna go over that right now. We're gonna use this much of this right here. We're gonna use that much of that. All right, I don't know what the ounces came to with that. A little bit left in here, so we're going to pour that in there too, because Grease Lightning is really, really, really strong stuff. That's 14 right there. 14. All right, now we're going to put some Zep 505. It's got some more D-limonene mixed in with it, so we're going to put some of that in there. We got to clean this place up. I'm mad at it. All right, now that wasn't enough. We're going to go just crazy. That's ammonia right there, folks. Check for editing in the video. See if it looks like there's any breaks in the film here. All right, there we go. Get that out of the way. And here we've got about half of this, half the clear volume 40. All right. And clear volume 40, it's pure oxygen is what it is. A gentleman asked me the other day, question, basically, in a video, why I didn't use sodium percarbonate, which is basically OxyClean. Use OxyClean because OxyClean is not pure oxygen. I add pure oxygen that way. I know what I put in there. I'm not gonna be able to get water out of that. Anyway, when you add sodium percarbonate, you're changing the pH again. So I don't like to use that stuff. I like to keep my oxygen and my alkalinity separate. I can go into that in different videos. I'm not going to go into that here. Anyway, I want everybody to know exactly when you reach your carpet like this, exactly how much thought goes into the pre-spray. Keep in mind, I've been at it for my 23rd year doing this. So I wouldn't be showing this. This is all stuff that you will not see on any other carpet channels because they're afraid to show it and they're embarrassed to show it. And this is how you get carpet clean. You know, those guys hang out in those Facebook groups and they talk about this and talk about that. And if you'll just buy this for me for $75, you can get your carpet clean. I'm not selling anything. Nothing I have here is for sale. It's not at Walmart or Home Depot. So I make zilch when you buy these products. But what I do is I get to help a couple of young guys maybe forego some of the costly lessons I learned in the beginning about buying everything somebody wanted to sell me. Counter is a bottle of Palmolive. So let's put a little squirt of that in here. We can get a little, at least that's a pH of about a 7 here. Stir that all up because it's Palmolive. Safe for your hands. All right, now, make no mistake. We're starting out with a scrub before we do any extracting at all. All right, what I'm going to do, I'm going to make this room here basically be about all of the cleaning because I've got the most wide open area here. But we're going to do a before and after on these two rooms. Basically, I'm just going to come in here and I'm going to clean this in the hallway and get this out of the way. And then when I get here, this is where the video is going to start. So I'm going to go ahead and clean those two, and then we'll come back and have a quick look, and then we'll be out here cleaning. So I've got to try to expedite the video some kind of way because it takes several steps to get one clean when it is bad off. All right, here we go. Now all I did was scrub it. So I didn't clean it yet, I just scrubbed it. So the dirt's still in here, it's just gonna get removed now. So I'm gonna go ahead and put a little light pre-spray. And I upped my pre-spray again. Already upped it, so I'm gonna put another light coat down. Then I'm gonna run just a regular Challenger bonnet over it. This is what I ran over it. This is a bonnet made by Mighty that I actually really like. They seem to be holding up really well. And I've only got a few of them. I got them along with I bought a Mighty machine used several years ago, January of 2021, actually. So those came with it. And that's really all I've used, the pads that came with it. I've used the machine about 3 times. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and knock that out right quick. And then we'll resume the video in here where I can work and talk a little bit. what I'm gonna do now, I'm actually gonna do this one here in time lapse just to get some cleaning in the video here. And then I'll do this one last in real time. I'll be able to open the front door up and kind of watch and see. We don't have police in this town anymore. So who knows, I'll be running through that door any minute now. All right, anyway, I said I'm gonna do this one here in time lapse. So we're gonna zoom through this one. And then over here, real time. And then we'll look over it all. So I'm gonna be running around in here for about 30 seconds is about as long as this will take in time lapse to do. Now we're going to do this one. I don't know how it's going to look best. The door open, the door closed. I think this way. Because I'll put it over there by the door, and I look over there, and the camera's gone. And what am I to do? You know? So we're gonna err on the side of caution and keep the camera closer to me rather than over there in no man's land. Alright. Now we're gonna do a bunch of stuff to carpet that they say don't do. Right now we're gonna do that. Alright, first thing, turn the fan off. I'm still scrubbing with this. It's for the girl Cynthia, I believe, that watches. Dirty towels. Another one over here, I believe. You know, that dirty, you never get it all out. All right, now we're gonna pre-spray really heavy. Probably almost use this up by the time we're down here. I need to try to use it up anyway so I can use my second jug for CO2. we're gonna do some scrubbing. All right, now we're gonna do the extraction here. I've got it all scrubbed and ready to clean. So we're gonna do the extraction. We're gonna change out bonnets and clean her up, make her look good. Somebody in the garage fixing the garage door right now. Four used Challenger bonnets. This is a small one. We ought to get higher RPM out of it, so we're going to run a smaller glider. Getting more RPM out of it. All right, we went from brand new to as dirty as you're gonna get it in one cleaning, and it's only been used on one side. So that gives you an accurate idea about how much soil you can extract. And you turn it over and you can see how this side is much lighter than this side. So you got more room here to extract soil here. And then if I were to flip it over and do the exact same thing to this side, I would need to wash it at least 3 times to get all that soil out of the bonnet on a heavy, heavy wash. All right, now what we're gonna do is we're gonna do a final pass over for the dry bonnet. Just because this is the first room you're gonna walk into, and we want it to look, you know, really amazing when the guy that hired me to do this comes and looks, you know, so he'll go, "Well, Jesus Christ, I had no idea you could do this to the carpet." So you keep coming back, keep putting out good quality work, and they'll return to you. And I've been cleaning for this guy for hell, I don't know how many years now. This bonnet here, I'm sorry, this wire, we're gonna use this one here. This is not available anywhere, only I've got these. Anyway, we're gonna use this guy here, dry. We're gonna give it a quick once over with a pre-spray, and then we're gonna run this over right quick before we groom it. For the last time. All right, I'm gonna put it in time lapse for this. Opened up the door and looked outside. Now I'm blind. I can't see anything in here. All right, guys. CLO2 time now. What I did here is I've got 4 tablets of CLO2 in there and a shot of peroxide. Reason being for the peroxide is a more powerful oxidizer than the chlorine dioxide is. So in the event, it's a little humid feeling in here. In the event, anything would start to wick. The peroxide would block it from wicking more so than the chlorine dioxide would. So anyway, I'm gonna go We're gonna treat this right quick. And it did take a lot of testing before I was comfortable mixing peroxide with CLO2. Plenty of that at the house, in the garage, in the kitchen, testing parts per million and testing every possible way. I thought I could screw up the carpet with it and bleach it, and I was unable to. I think I mixed CLO2 with everything but maybe napalm to try to see if I could get any kind of reaction out of it, and I wasn't able to. I watched all the videos. I did everything the way I was told, parts per million, and none of that basically came out to be true. Everything that they were reporting in the videos erred on the side of caution, which is fine. But your perimeters as far as what you can do and what you're told to do are just like usual, two entirely different things. But I'm not telling anybody to do anything you're uncomfortable doing. I'm just showing you what I'm doing. So, it's up to you. That's the AC vent there. I don't see how that little vent couldn't hurt right over there. Or the AC inlet, rather. All right, now we're gonna rub it in just a little bit, just for the sport of it. We've got the AC blowing at about 70, which is, it's all right. I'd rather have it blowing about 63. Probably nobody gonna be coming around later in order to cut it back. I'm adding a lot of extra moisture back to the carpet, and I've used a lot cleaning it. So, you know, just for erring on the side of caution, you always want to try to create an environment where the carpet will dry better. And being that I've added all this extra moisture to it, running AC as cold as I think I can get away with, as humid as it is right now, it could freeze up. So that's why I bumped it up a little bit. And I had the door open, so that didn't help any at all. Let more humidity in. It'll be another couple days before my nose works after all this. now the last part here. One thing I'm going to point out before we leave here on the carpet, I don't know if anybody's seen it yet, but I've been looking at it the whole time and I'm forgetting to show you. On the roof first, we're going to look at where the carpet is either one or two things. One, the grain is reversed, or two, it's just a different color carpet. Can't really tell. And it can be either. Now, I'm going to take a look at the carpet. All right, everything looks pretty uniform there, but over here, as you get toward the door, you can see there's a difference in the shade of the carpet here. What's going on there is either the carpet has been turned 180 degrees and installed, and the grain doesn't match, and when the grain doesn't match, it looks a little darker, a little lighter. If you put them, like if you were to take either one of these carpets and turn it around and point it the other way, you would probably have a match. But I don't know that it's not two different colors of carpet that have been put together for a fairly good match. I don't know. But anyway, it's just something that I like to point out whenever I find this in videos, because there was one time I was cleaning in somebody's apartment years and years ago, and the lady, she says to me, she goes, "Why is it so clean over here, but then over here on this side, it's not as clean?" I said, "Well, ma'am, what I did was I realized how good it was working. And when I got over here, I said, the hell with it. I'm done doing that good. I'm not going to get it this clean. I'm only going to get it this clean." No, I didn't say that. I explained that to her. Anyway, it just makes sense. You know, people ask you questions and, you know, you need to be able to answer them some kind of way. And you're not going to have this come up in an IICRC meeting, and they're not going to tell you about this. The only way you're going to learn this is if you watch this channel. All right, guys, that does it. I got a video I did yesterday that I haven't put up yet. Now there's this one I did today. So I'm going to try to put this one up tonight if I can. It's been a really bad week for video because I've been doing a lot of stuff that just doesn't transpose to video, working around families and stuff and talking to them. And I don't like to shoot video when I'm, you know, conversing with my clients. All right, have a good afternoon. I hope the video helps somebody. And if you're interested in purchasing Challenger, you've got a few more days until the 31st of this month. It's $350 off. After that, it's full price again. The only thing you'll get back is $100 from me for purchasing it through my dealership. Thanks for watching. God bless, and see you on the next video.